Hello, my name is Rosemary Sanchez and I am a product marketing engineer for Texas Instruments transceiver interface product line. In this video, I will explain the operation of TI's multi-switch detection interface, or MSDI portfolio. We'll discuss threshold adjustments found in TI's MSDI devices, the modes of operation, the sampling sequence, and their power supply. As covered in Texas Instruments MSDI Overview Precision Labs video, MSDI stands for Multi-Switch Detection Interface. Texas Instruments offers three MSDI products with all devices being capable of monitoring 24 direct switch inputs in a 12-volt system. They monitor the switches by using internal current sources and sink currents to simultaneously supply the switch with wetting current and monitor the voltage drop across the switch. Texas Instruments MSDI devices provide six different wetting current settings, 0, 1, 2, 5, 10, and 15 milliamp, and depending on the system's application and power and thermal management needs, Texas Instruments MSDI devices can supply the wetting current in two different modes, continuous and polling mode. All modes allowing the microcontroller to be configured to enable or disable monitoring of all or some of the 24 inputs available. In continuous mode, the wetting current is supplied continuously to each enabled input channel and sequentially sampled. The wetting current is not disabled while the other inputs are being sampled and can result in a higher power consumption and higher device temperatures if multiple switches are closed for prolonged amounts of times. However, since the wetting current is supplied continuously, the input is always ready to be sampled, which allows for a fast sampling time. This graph is an example of the polling sequence in continuous mode. Polling mode reduces the power consumption and device temperature by periodically applying the wetting current based on a programmable timer, only when sampling the input channel and disabling the wetting current otherwise. This graph is an example of the polling sequence in standard polling time. When activated, wetting current is applied to each input for a pre-programmed polling active time, and then the input voltage is sampled in sequential order and then disabled for a period of time to reduce overall system current consumption. The TIC-12400Q1 and the TIC-12400 also enable matrix mode. In these devices, a special input switch matrix can be configured and monitored in addition to the standard switches to ground and supply voltage. For example, this figure shows how the TIC-12400Q1 can support up to 36 switch inputs by using only 12 switch input pins of the TIC-12400Q1. Half the pins are used to source the current and the other half are used to sink current and monitor the voltage. By sourcing current to a particular column and then sinking current on various rows, individual switches can be monitored by this row or column configuration. Three different matrix configurations are possible, 4x4, 5x5, and 6x6, and are defined by the matrix bits. If the matrix bits are set to 0, all inputs are treated as a standard input with identical polling active time. Any setting other than 0 for matrix bits causes a polling active time for the matrix input to be configured according to the polling active time setting bits in the matrix register. However, when matrix polling is selected, continuous mode is not available to the standard inputs outside of the matrix input group. This feature could be useful to monitor a special configuration called matrix as required by specific OEMs. Regardless of the wetting current mode used, the MSDI device will pull the enabled input channels in a sequential style. After the first polling cycle, the switch status for each input is stored as a default state and compared with subsequent polling cycles. The interrupt pin is asserted low after the first polling cycle is complete to notify the microcontroller that the default switch status is ready to be read. At the end of each subsequent polling cycle, if any of the enabled input channels is different from the default state stored on the first cycle, the state change will be reflected in the status register that can be read, and a hardware interrupt will be passed to the MCU through the interrupt pin. The interrupt pin can be used for wake-up purposes to activate a voltage regulator via its inhibit or enable input based upon the MSDI device detecting a state change on one of the switch inputs. This implementation is specially used for waking up a microcontroller in sleep mode to allow significant system level power savings. As mentioned in the MSDI Overview Texas Instruments Precision Lab video, Texas Instruments offers three devices, the TIC-12400Q1 and the TIC-12400. Both have a comparator and ADC option for each input channel and can be used with either digital or analog switches. But the TIC-10024Q1 only has a comparator and can only be used to detect digital type switches. After selecting which inputs would monitor ground connector switches or supply connector switches, either ADC or comparator mode is selected, and then thresholds need to be pre-programmed so the MSDI can distinguish between open and closed switch states. In ADC mode, the thresholds can be programmed to any of the 1023 codes. In comparator mode, there are four preset reference threshold voltages to choose from, and they are 2, 2.7, 3, and 4 volts. The adjustable threshold allows the system designer to use MSDI to mitigate some non-idealities in the switch detection systems. These MSDI devices operate mostly from the battery supply voltage and do not need the lower drain voltage supply that powers the MCU and SPI bus. This low drain voltage is only needed for SPI communication and is usually used to power the microcontroller, so when the device is configured, the MCU can be put to sleep and the VDD rail disabled to save power. Because the battery supply voltage is always present, the MSDI device will retain the register configuration and can properly monitor the switches and generate an interrupt to enable the VDD supply rail and power up the MCU. For example, whenever you park your car, most of its electrical components would be put asleep or in low power mode. The MSDI device has the capability to stay active and detect switch changes, such as from a key unlocking the vehicle, and wake or enable the VDD regulator and the MCU, which will then send a signal that will allow you to unlock your car and drive off. Texas Instruments MSDI devices have many characteristics that can be configured to fit systems application needs. Those characteristics include adjustable thresholds in either ADC or comparator mode, and different modes of operation, which include continuous, polling, and matrix mode. Through this presentation, you can see that Texas Instruments MSDI devices prove to have many features that will benefit customers. To find more MSDI technical resources and search products, visit ti.com/MSDI.